Hello, everyone. Welcome to Children's Church. Now, I don't know what the weather's like where you are, but here with me, it's very cold. So, I'm wearing my bunny onesie. What are you wearing today? Now, because it's so cold, only Stella and Dino joined me today. Everybody else decided they were staying under the blankets. Are you ready for us to begin with Children's Church? Great. So let's begin by opening in prayer. You're going to close your eyes and you're going to put your hands together. You're going to say after me.
Let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, I know today is in your hands, and tomorrow will be too. I know everything is changing, but that's okay because you love me. And I know I can trust you. Please be with me today. Amen.
So because I'm chilly, I need to do a little bit of warming up. Are you going to join me while we do some warming up before we begin worship? Awesome. So make sure you've got somewhere to stand and make sure you're ready to do some dancing. Are you ready? Let's go.
There's a kitty in an oak tree. Let's all go and fly real high. People by day, heroes by night. We fight for good with all our might. And we will do anything to save the world tonight. Together,
All right. So are you all warmed up? Are you ready to go? Let's sing together.
I've got peace, love, and joy like a river. just living in me can change the world.
Time for us to check in with our liturgical clock. Let's see where we are on the church calendar today. Do you know which block we're on? Can you point to it with your finger? That's right, we are in the time of the green growing Sundays. Sometimes in church they call this ordinary time. Sometimes the word for it is proper time. We call them green growing Sundays. It's time for us to get ready for a story. Shall we begin to get ready for our story together? Now, let's get ready for our story together.
So make sure that you're sitting somewhere comfortable. Have you put down everything that might distract you? Now let's take a deep breath in and breathe slowly out again. Are you looking for that quiet place inside yourself? You know, the place you go when you talk to God. Are you ready for a story? Good. Let's begin. Look, the box is the color gold. There may be a parable inside because parables are as valuable or even more valuable than gold. The box also looks like a present. Parables are presents. They were given to you before you were born. They are yours, even if you don't know what they are. This box looks old, and parables are old. Maybe there really is one inside. Do you see the lid? It looks like a closed door. Sometimes parables seem closed to us, even if we are ready to enter them. You need to keep coming back for them, and one day they'll open for you. I know what. Let's look inside and see if there is a parable there. I wonder what it could be. Could it be a mountain? What do you think? Maybe it's just a hill. Or some sand? Wonder what it is. I wonder what this could really be. It doesn't look like much now. It certainly is brown. It's all brown. Everywhere there is anything, there is brown. I'm sure there are many other things in the box, but there's nothing left to help us get ready. So all we can do now is begin. There once was someone who did such amazing things and said such wonderful things that people followed him. As they followed him, they heard him speaking about a kingdom. The kingdom was not like one they were in. It was not like one that anyone had ever visited. It was not like any kingdom anyone had ever heard about. So they had to ask him, "What is the kingdom of heaven like?" One day, when they asked him that, he said, "The kingdom of heaven is like when a sower, someone who scatters seeds, goes out and scatters seeds along the path. As the sower sowed seeds along the path, the birds of the air came and ate the seeds. The sower also sowed seeds among the stones.
When the seeds tried to put their little roots down among the stones, they could not push their way into the ground. When the sun came out, it scorched the seeds, and they died. The sower also scattered seeds among the thorns. When the seeds tried to push their little roots down among the thorns, they could push them in a little bit of the way, but the thorns choked them and they died. The sower also scattered seeds in the good earth. When the seeds pushed their little roots down into the good earth, they could go all the way in. The seeds grew and grew. The harvest was 30, 60, and 100 bushels. Now, I wonder what part of this story you liked best. I wonder if the sower had a name. I wonder what the harvest could really be.
That's all we've got time for today. I'm going to go and get back under my blanket because I'm freezing. I wonder what you're going to do now. So, before we go, why don't we join together and say the benediction so that we can end Children's Church properly? You're going to say after me.
May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen.
I lay my life down at your feet. You're the only one.